Welcome to our lecture online. Just to make sure we know how to use this technique, let's do one more example of using the quadratic formula just to not solve, but to factor a trinomial. So again, we're going to assume that this is equal to zero, even though it's not equal to zero. So we're going to use this technique, and then we just ignore the equal to zero part and use the very same technique to what we call solve the quadratic equation. So we can write that x is going to be equal to the negative b, which is 10, plus or minus the square root of negative 10 squared, b squared, minus 4 times a times c. The whole thing divided by, let's see here, that would be 2a, or 2 times 1. Simplifying that, we get x is equal to 10 plus or minus the square root of 100 minus 84 divided by 2, which can be simplified to be 10 plus or minus the square root of 16 divided by 2, which is equal to 10 plus or minus 4 divided by 2, and that leaves us two possibilities. We have x is equal to 10 plus 4, which is 14 divided by 2, which is 7, or 10 minus 4, which is 6 divided by 2, which is 3. X equals 3, which means the original trinomial can be factored to be equal to x minus 7, because we take the opposite signs, times x minus 3. And that is how we quickly, using the quadratic formula, find the proper factored form of our trinomial, and that is how it's done.